Hey good people, it's your girl Christina here, coming to you guys with another video. I thank God for each and every person who liked, who was inspired, who commented, who shared, who called, who tweeted, who inboxed me. I thank you guys. I thank God that he is blessing and moving in people's lives. I thank God that my message can inspire somebody to want to dig a little deeper, to dig a little further, to do some self-evaluation. I thank God for that. Real talk. I truly, truly do. So I bless God for each and every one of you guys. And I pray that these messages continue to encourage y'all. I'm coming to you guys tonight with a real small video. It's not super, super long. I just had a long, long weekend. It was fun. It was fun, but it was just, I haven't got that much sleep. And school starts tomorrow, so I want to get my mind fresh because it's like that little break that they gave. It was just little, but whatever. Thank God for that, right? But yeah, so this video, I named this video, Hit the Restart Button. So let's get into the video. I named this video Hit the Restart Button because a lot of us deal with a lot of past childhood trauma, hurt, and pain. A lot of us grew up in an unhealthy environment, whether it was drug abuse, physical abuse, verbal abuse, alcohol abuse, sexual abuse. Some people grew up in a foster home. Some people grew up in the streets. Some people grew up, you know, parents addicted to drugs. Some people grew up, mother was a prostitute, father wasn't around or beat no mom. It's just an unhealthy situation, you know. And these days, the parents are getting younger and younger. So, you know, you got parents, children raising children. I was a young mom myself. I had my first son when I was 16. So I didn't know nothing about being a mother. And speaking in, you know, just in life, speaking to a lot of people, I hear a lot how, you know, a lot of people feel their life will be better if a situation wouldn't occur as a child. My life will be better if my mother was this way. My life will be better if my father was in my life. My life wouldn't be this way if I wouldn't have got molested. My life wouldn't be this way if my mother wasn't on drugs and so on and so on. But this video, I want to encourage you that you can hit the restart button. It's never too late to hit the restart button. Yeah, your mom may not have been the mother that she should have been, but now you are an adult, and it's not too late for you to recreate the life that you really want to live. You don't have to live in bondage with the hate and the bitterness of something that happened to you as a child. Yes, our parents are responsible for a lot of things that and how we act as an adult, but as an adult, it's our responsibility to turn that around. So you have an opportunity now in this season, in this moment, to hit the restart button. Your life don't have to go the way that it started. Your father wasn't there. Don't mean that you still have to take abandonment issues with you into your next season. You can hit the restart button. Your mother was abusive. Doesn't mean you have to take those abusive ways and them damaged and broken ways into the next season. You can hit the restart button. If you was molested as a child, you can have all type of walls up and trust issues coming into an adult life, but you don't have to take that into your next season. You can hit the restart button. I tell, even had to tell myself, a lot of things that I was holding hostage, that was holding me hostage as a kid, was stopping me from getting to the things that I desired in life. I didn't want to live the life I lived when I found out it was so much more to have in this world. And I'm not just talking about things. I'm talking about an experience and stuff, an experience. And I'm like, it was so much more that I couldn't, I felt like I just couldn't get to it. But then I figured it out, like, well, through the wisdom God gave me, I figured it out that it was the more I was letting go and starting creating new stuff, it's like the closer I was getting to the things that I felt like, why do I have to live like this? Just because I grew up like this, you don't have to. I decided to hit the restart button. And when I hit the restart button, I set new rules. I set new standards. I set new things in my life. Cause I'm like, if I had a bitter, if I was bitter in my heart, I couldn't keep going keep going into my future with bitterness because that was going to block joy and peace. So I'm like, I have to restart this. Okay, I was raised this way. I was abused. I was physically abused. I was verbally abused. I was mistreated. But if I carry this into my adult life, it's over here and it ain't getting me nowhere. And it's causing a whole lot of chaos in my life as a mother, as a sister, as a wife, as a everything. It's just not clicking stuff. And I got to hold myself responsible for the role that I play. So how do I make this right? I can't go back and make my mother re-raise me. So I could be mad all day at my mother, but she can't re-raise me. I can go back to my father and be mad at him, but he can't re-raise me. But what I can do is hit the restart button and create a whole new thing for myself. If this is something that you deal with and you know it deep down inside, I got these control issues because I don't trust, because something happened to me as a child, then now I don't trust nobody in my adult life. But you keep finding yourself running in circles and circles and circles, because nobody wants to be controlled or could like deal with somebody that doesn't trust them. But you don't have to be that way. You can hit the restart button. And I encourage a lot of people to go to counseling. If you don't know how to live the life outside of the life that you normally do, but you know it has to be more than this, then they have people that can talk to you, to inspire you, to encourage you, and teach you. It's adults that can teach you healthier ways to have conversations. That's part of hitting the restart button. I'm not going to keep cussing people out because that's what I was told. My mother cussed me out all the time. My father cussed me out all the time. So now I cuss everybody out all the time. But that don't get you anywhere. That's not going to get you to that place that you really want to go. That's not going to get you to that relationship that you really deserve. That's not going to get you into that building, that business that you really want to run, because you got a stink attitude. You got a disrespectful mouth because that's how you were raised. But you can hit the restart button right now so you can get to those things. You don't have to carry what was done to you over into your seat next season. You don't have to carry that over. You can hit the restart button. And when you hit the restart button, don't go back and play those games, because it didn't get you nowhere thus far. A lot of hurt, heart, and pain. And I'm not giving none of our past history an excuse of, okay, it happened and so what. What I'm saying is, it happened is nothing we can do to go back to rewrite it. But we can start creating a new for us by hitting the restart button. We can go back, and it's some people that will never apologize. It's some parents that would never admit to the wrong they done to give their child peace about the understanding. But you have the power. You have the power to hit the restart button. You can forgive them. They don't even have to be around. They don't even have to be in your space. Let it, forgive them in your heart and let it go. How do I forgive somebody who molested me? Because they not thinking about it, honey. They done moved on with their life. They done molested some more kids. They done went and been more perverts, probably got married and had some more. And you sitting stuck, bound, and mad because of something they done to you as a child. Get the counseling that you need to give you the tools that help you hit the restart button so you can walk into something better. You can walk into something greater. You don't have to turn that take that molestation into your marriage, and now you trying to figure out why it never worked. I'm giving it my all, but you giving all that happened to you. You ain't giving all that it can be, because you giving all that happened to you. Hit the restart button. Don't let stuff that happened in your past continue to show up in your present right now and ruin your future. Hit the restart button. So I wanted to encourage you on tonight. If it's somebody, anything that you're dealing with that's causing you to keep you bound and locked up and in bondage because it happened to you as a child, find it in your heart to let it go. You know what? I can't change it. Even if he admit that he touched me, even if she admit that she mistreated me, even if he admit that he ain't raised me, would that really make my life change in this moment? The only thing that will make your life change in this moment is you hitting the restart button. Take control of your life. Take control of your life. You have the power from God to move into a future that is super great for you. You do not have to be what happened to you. You are more than that. The enemy used that to keep you bound. It's the setup. It was a trick. It's a trick. It's a trick. If God allowed me to let this happen to her as a child, she'll never come out and be free. She'll let this hold her for the rest of her life. And I have her by her neck for the rest of her life. She 45 and still mad at her mother. She 52 and she still hate her daddy. I got her right by the neck, God. I got her. God, like, all you got to do is let it go. Because the devil only have power when you give it to him. The meanwhile, you thinking you living, but the enemy still got you jacked up by the neck by something that happened to you as a child. I was mistreated. I was treated bad, honey. I did not come up like I should have. I felt like it could have been better and it should have been better. But if I hold that against my mother, for right now, I am an adult. I had to become a mother quick, way before I should have, because I was a young mother. But I had to let it go, because now I didn't have time to hold that, because I had to figure out, how am I going to raise kids? I didn't have time to hold that, because now I got to figure out how to be a wife. I ain't had time to hold that. I got to figure out how to be this. I got to figure out how to do that, because I'm like, I want to get into all the greater things that I'm supposed to be is the woman I'm going to evolve into, but I can't get there if I'm over here. I can't get there if I'm still over here. I have realized we'll grow up, but we still mentally, it's like immature. Like, we'll be 50, but we still 12. And I'm like, oh my God, the only way I'm like, but you still acting like you was when you were a child. You have to grow up and you have to restart. You have to reset for yourself, because if you're stuck as a child if you're stuck back in the time when things happened to you as a child, then as an adult, you're still stuck in that mindset. So that's what I mean. Like, oh my God, she's 50, but she's acting 12, because she's still stuck right there. Still stuck right there. And I know it hurt. And I know it was painful. And I know it wasn't right. It was not fair. We did not ask for that. We were children. That shouldn't have never happened to you. They shouldn't have never touched you. They shouldn't have never mistreated you. That sucks. But as an adult, you can restart that. You can turn that into something amazing. So the enemy will have to let you go. He will have to flee. But until then, he will have you jacked up by the neck. And you think you moving, but you not. Because he got a hold on you by your past. But I encourage you on tonight to hit the restart button. Hit the restart button. You want to be an amazing man, honey. If you want to go to the next level in your life, you want to evolve as a father, you want to be a better husband, hit the restart button. Nobody never taught me how to be a wife. Nobody never taught me how to be a mother. But I was so eager to learn that I had to start letting go stuff. It was so much stuff on my plate. I'm like, I need to make room to learn new things. I had to make room, so I decided I gotta hit the restart button. I say, when I hit the restart button, I'm trying to hit the restart button on everything. And the ultimate restart button is giving your life to Christ. Because once you give your life to him, honey, it all will be set free. If you have to be willing, though. You have to be open in the heart, not that halfway yes stuff. Y'all know how I am with that. That sitting on the fence stuff. You got to be like, yeah, God, I'm ready. I'm ready to go in. Come get me. Come take me. Touch me. You know, fill me up. Make me brand new. And he will make you brand new. The things that used to hurt you, look at the person that molested you, because the enemy will ask permission to try to taunt you, to make you feel some type of way. But use it. I always use it as exercise. I be like, yeah, he trying to trip me up. You held me bound in hostage for too long, honey. I hit the reset button for a reason. I'm not trying to still be in a on a fifth level when I'm supposed to be on the 25th level in my life at this point. But I'm stuck on a fifth because I'm still letting an enemy hold me because my mama was on drugs. I'm like, nah, honey, hit the reset button. Your mother should have raised you better than that. That should not have happened to you. But we are adults now, and you have the power to turn your life around. I tell people all the time, when my mother, she raised me, and then I got children, I raised them right. So we have to, as we get older, you have to create, I always say, create an umbrella for yourself. My children have to create an umbrella for themselves. It's things that I shouldn't have done, raising them, and I teach them the same thing. But I'm real honest about my mistakes with my children. If I did it, I will admit to it, I will apologize, and I will even explain the mindset I was in. If I knew better, I knew better. I just didn't do better. And if I knew better, I didn't do better. And I would say that. I'm comfortable with my flaws. I'm comfortable with things that I didn't do that was right, because I'm not that woman no more. So I don't feel no type like, I don't want to stay there because I don't want people to know. I'm not that person no more. So it don't even matter, you know, because I hit the restart button. So you talking about stuff that the game that I was on prior to right now, I don't mind discussing that. It was going to help encourage you to get out into another place, to push you into another place, because I'm not that woman no more. I decided to hit the restart, but I had to create an umbrella of my own because I was still carrying my mother's umbrella. I was still carrying my mother's umbrella, the umbrella of abuse and verbal abuse and physical abuse and neglect and being mistreated. That was my umbrella, because now I'm an adult, so I have to give her umbrella and create my own. And that's what I say when my children, they have umbrellas as well. I just feel like now that they're grown, they have to create their own umbrella. If you want your life to be set up another way, you want to live a certain lifestyle, because everybody in this lifestyle stuff, you want to have peace and joy in your heart, and you want to be happy, you have to give back the umbrella to the past and create a new one. Start, hit the restart button. You do not have to carry that stuff in your life. You don't have to have it right now. You don't have to be angry all the time. Hit the restart button. I encourage you to get on your knees, pray to God. God, help me to restart my life. This happened to me, God. This is how it make me feel. Confess. God can help. The truth will set you free. The truth will set you free. God already know about it. Confess it. God, when I was little, this hurt me and this makes me feel this way. I believe this is why I'm so bitter. I believe this is why I'm so mad. This is why I'm so stubborn. This is why I'm so moody. Like, God, this thing has been riding me for many, many years, God. But I need you to help me to hit the restart button. I want to show up in this world as a better woman, as a better man. God, I don't want to leave this world bitter, and that's all I came here to be, is bitter. I don't want that to be. God did not let you, he did not allow you to come here just to be molested or mistreated and say that's going to be your life. You hold on to that and that be that. No, honey, you got more. God got more in store for you. His word tells us that his plan is to prosper us and do us no harm. His plan is to give us hope in the future. If God said that is the plan for you, then there's an amazing things in store for you. Don't let your past hold you hostage. Hit the reset button. Open your mouth. Confess to God. If it's counseling you have to see, seek counsel. Look, I don't know how to be a man. I don't know how to be a father. I don't know how to be this. I just need somebody to teach me the right way, because what I was taught ain't getting me there. What I was taught ain't taking me nowhere. I'm just, no disrespect to nobody, parents or nothing. I told my kids some jacked up stuff too. I wasn't all bad, but I was bad as I don't know what now. Don't get me wrong. I already made a whole, I talk about that all the time. I ain't ashamed to say that, honey. I was terrible when it came to certain things raising my kids. I mean, Lord Jesus, I ain't had no skills. I'm like, Lord, where was the child protective service? But it's like, no, it wasn't like I was killing them with that. But I will have punched them in the face. I don't play that disrespect stuff. But seriously though, y'all, I truly encourage you guys, man, if that's something that you found, that you find yourself struggling with, and the enemy still got you held hostage about something that happened in the past, I'm sorry that it happened to you. I'm sorry that it is such a burden on you. But I encourage you on today to hit the reset button. You have the power to. God has the power. The power that rose Jesus from the dead is inside of you as well. Just activate it. Hit the reset button. Hit the reset button. Talk to God. Talk, find somebody that can help you, teach you and encourage you on pushing the restart button. Life don't have to be this way. It don't have to be you still carrying around your past umbrella. It's time to create a new umbrella for yourself. One that has your name all on it. One that you know, I'm going to rewrite this. I'm going to redo this. No, yeah, I may was abused, but I ain't walking into my story ain't going to end that way. It's not going to say here lies such and such who just got abused as a child and she let it ride all the way through her life. No, you don't have to read that way. You have the power to hit the restart button. Real talk, good people. I truly, truly thank God for you good people. I pray to God that somebody decides to hit the reset button. Again, I'm praying for anybody who's seen me, heard me, who know me, anybody who thought of me in any type of way. My prayers are with you guys. I decided to do this video real short. Like I said, I gotta get some rest. But I truly, truly pray that this video encourage you guys. Somebody on tonight, please decide to hit the reset button. Please decide to start confessing those things to God. God has the power to heal. It's nothing that he cannot heal. I am trying to tell you, I was hurt. My heart was damaged. I was broken. I was just all kind of stuff. I came up real rough and tough, man. I really did. But I thank God, because if it wasn't for those things, I wouldn't be able to sustain some stuff that happened to me as an adult. I could have been bitter about it, but I used it. It was strength. I was like, if that wouldn't have happened, I probably wouldn't have made it to this. If that wouldn't happen, Lord knows I wouldn't have made it. Because I got touched, I didn't trust my children to just go any and everywhere. Me getting touched was a bad thing, but I made it work for my good, because I could have been one of those mothers who just let their kids spend the night over everybody's house and be like, oh, well, you know, I'm just naive to somebody molesting them. But because I got touched, I knew, I was like, nope, can't go there, can't go this, you know, we're not doing all that. You know, I'm like, so I wasn't with that. So it's not that it was a good thing, but I took it and made it a good, made it, for something good or later in my life. I was abused, you know, I became an abuser, and I'm like, okay, this is not cool. I had to check myself, and I knew that type of behavior and that type of aggressiveness and the way that I was not going to get me into the space that I needed to be. When I read that God said, these are the plans that I have for you. And I'm like, well, why they ain't coming for me? And I'm serving you, God. I'm giving you my heart for real. And I'm on the line, I'm ushering, I'm doing what I got to do in the church. I'm paying my tithes. I'm turning out, you know, I'm doing things that his words say. I'm walking into things, but I still kept feeling stuck. But what I wasn't doing, I still was carrying an umbrella of things in my past, and God had to remind me of that. And that's why it's important to have a relationship with God. Because when you'll be on your journey, you'll be sitting at work, walking to work, getting in the car, getting some coffee, and he'll start talking to you. Like, nah, or you'll say something wrong, and he like, nah, that's not what you're supposed to do. Like, that's why you haven't got there, because you have to let go of that stuff so you can make room for other things that I have for you. Just because your mother raised you, but you are my child at the beginning and the end of the day. God bless y'all, good people. Y'all enjoy the rest of y'all day. Y'all enjoy the rest of y'all night. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, and all that other good stuff. Until the next time, peace.